Hello and welcome to another Scriptcase Fundamentals training. In this class, you will learn how to use the log module with your security setup and Scriptcase applications for event tracking. Using the multiple log schemas, each application can be linked to a different log schema, which can be configured individually. Each project can have one or more log schemas applied to its applications, allowing you to track data separately. To access the log schemas list, you need to access the main menu, modules, and then log. Now here you have then the option to create and edit your log module. Clicking that will open the new schema options. Since I have no schema yet, I need to first create it first. And to create a schema, we need to first define some basic options. The log schema name, a description, the connection, and the table in which the log information will be stored. Each of these fields are required other than the description. If the table already exists, then you can also drop or delete the table on creation, which will remove the old table and create a new one for the log module. You also have the option to set a default schema for the project and define the variable that is being used to store the login information. This variable must be the same used within the security module and ideally throughout your project. By default, Scriptcase sets the variable on both modules as user_login as a global variable within brackets. This is the default user variable used by the security module also, and we have this displayed here within the login field. For default values below, there are two options: events, which are actions that will be stored in the log table, and recording mode, which is user data that will be stored in the log table. Here you can add or remove the data that you want logged within the log, and you could essentially create a different log for each type of event that you wanted. In the recording mode, you can select to only store the key or all fields that have been inserted, updated, and or deleted. So I'll go ahead and fill in these details, and I'll first of all provide a name. We'll call it sample log. I will leave the description as it's not really required. I have my connection selected, and I will use the default sc_log title for my table. And I'm just going to go ahead and delete the table if it already exists. And when I'm ready, I can go ahead and click the save button. So clicking save will then open the confirmation screen. So here we have indicated that the table has been created successfully. We can close to save the schema. We can view the SQL code used, and we can also download the SQL. So I'll go ahead and close the schema and save it for the time being. Now once saved, you will be redirected to the project log schema. Here you can then define which log schema will be used for each project application. The list of applications and schema of displayed applications can be filtered at the bottom. There you can search for specific schemas in use or also view by application. At the top, you can apply actions to all rows at once, or you can select one action for each row individually. You can apply what will be used for the applications, such as the user date that will be stored in the log table, as well as the events to store the information: access, insert, update, and also delete. In this log report, you can see all stored information according to the schema selected during the report creation. The log schema, application name, folder where the application will be stored, and the theme that will be used for the log application and the security module. Thank you for watching this part of the Scriptcase Fundamentals training. Once you have applied your schema, so if I select here to apply the schema to the sample log for all applications, I will select to save all fields and simply select the save button at the bottom. Once the applications have been saved, we can then also go ahead and create the log application. So again, we will access modules, log, and select the create, select applications related to the log. Once ready, we can close the application. We can access modules again, log, and create edit log module once again. Now here we will then be able to see the schemas or logging schemas which we have created and applied. Here we are then able to edit the applications again, create a new schema, and also create the application log to be used within our project. So I will go ahead and click create application log, and now I'm presented with the options for the application which will be created. So here I select the schema for which this log application will be applied. I can provide the application a name and also specify a folder where it will be stored. I can change the theme for this application as well as specify to use security for the logging application, which is most definitely advised. Once ready, we can go ahead and click the Create button. Now with the log created, you will be able to start collecting data regarding the usage, insert, act, insert, edit, delete, and so forth, as well as the login and logout of users within your platform. Thank you for watching this part of the Scriptcase Fundamentals training. I hope to see you again soon in the next class.